time for our children's story. So if we have, I think we only have one, two children today. All right. If you will get the little baskets and go around and collect the little green flags that you see people holding up, we would appreciate it. And Ruth is going to have our children's story today. I didn't see Brianna. This is a macaw. There are 15 different species of macaw. There's blue ones, there's green ones, there's yellow ones. There's even purple ones, solid purple, purple with green. And they are all big birds. But this is the scarlet macaw. It has the most colors, and it looks like a rainbow. And when you have a whole flock of them flying through the sky, I can just imagine what heaven's going to look like. But our story this morning is a story about Scarlet. Scarlet was a red macaw. And this is a scarlet macaw. That's why her name is Scarlet. Okay. Well, Scarlet's owner, Miss Smith, was getting ready to go on vacation. Miss Smith was one of the Sabbath school teachers, and she was just loved by everyone. And when she went and was going on vacation, she was going to a place where she could not take Scarlet with her. Usually she took Scarlet everywhere. She took Scarlet to the grocery store, she took Scarlet to Walmart, she took Scarlet to the garden, anywhere and everywhere. And Scarlet never flew away. Well, she decided that she wanted to have a babysitter for Scarlet. So she asked three young people if they would take turns taking care of Scarlet, kind of like an interview, a test to see if that was a good fit, because Miss Smith was going to be gone for a whole month. So she made arrangements, and with Tammy and Cindy and Julie and their parents. And so the first person to take Scarlet home was Tammy. And Tammy put Scarlet in the living room where she could see everything and hear everything. And when Mother called and it was time to do her chores, Mother would say, "Tammy, oh, what do you want? Tammy, have you cleaned your room? No, I'll do it later." Well, that's what Scarlet heard every day. Well, the next week, he went to Cindy's house. Scarlet got to go to Cindy's house. Cindy had lots of animals. Cindy had fish, she had cats, she had a hamster, and it was her responsibility to feed all the pets. And the rule was, if the animals don't eat, you don't eat. So, because animals can't feed themselves, right? So Cindy was sitting doing her homework. Her mother said, "Cindy, oh Mom, do I have to?" "Cindy, it's time to feed the animals." "Oh Mom, they're so messy." "Cindy." "Okay." And so that's what Scarlet heard for the second week. Well, the third week, Scarlet got to go to Julie's house. And Julie had cleaned a particular corner of the living room and kept it all. She was fastidious. Do you know what fastidious means? It means she was so clean, she was a perfectionist. She couldn't have any crumbs anywhere. Well, Mother would call Julie. And Julie would say, "Coming, Mother! I'll be right there." And Julie would come in. And, "Julie, will you set the table?" "Oh, yes, Mama." "Julie, have you cleaned your room?" "I'll go do it right now." Well, after the 3 weeks was over, Scarlet got to go back home with Miss Smith. And everything was all wonderful. And Miss Smith invited Tammy and Cindy and Julie to come over for lunch. And then after lunch, she would tell them who got to take Scarlet home while she was gone for a month for vacation. They were all sitting around the table. And Miss Smith said, "Tammy!" And Scarlet said, "What do you want?" That's not the response Miss Smith was expecting. And then she said, "Cindy, do I have to?" And Tammy and Cindy looked at each other. And their faces turned red. Oh, they were so embarrassed. And then she said, "Julie." "Yes, ma'am." Who do you think got to take Scarlet home for that month of vacation? Julie got to take her home. You know, it's a lesson for us too. When we listen to things that are true, and we listen to things that are kind and honest, then in our hearts, we become kind and honest too. But if we're going to listen to things that are not so nice, we're going to listen to bad language or watch things on TV that are questionable, that make us agitated, and make us kind of cross, then that's going to come out of us too. We need to make sure that whatever we want to shine out of us is what we put into us. So if we want to have people seeing Jesus in our lives, we need to be careful and put Jesus into our lives. How do you put Jesus in your life? By spending time with our Bibles, with our lessons in nature, and being able to appreciate things that God has given to us. Would anybody like to have prayer? No? You want to pray?
Lord Jesus, I want to help my daddy to be better. I want to keep it in.
And Father, we thank you for the opportunity to worship you today. In Christ's name, amen.